I want to try to make this a very quick video. So first of all, when you play the game, you have to know two things. One, where do you respawn, and two, where is your walker? As you can see, you can build a variety of walker, and some of them are really, really crazy. Yeah, this one, oh, isn't she a beauty? She'll be once she's done. Also bigger and smaller, but you'll probably start with the small one. So this is perfectly viable. Just follow the quest until you can build a walker, but don't leave the map. If you leave the map and go, for example, to another oasis, you won't be able to come back. And the other maps are, well, very, very hard to play on because we have stronger monsters, more aggressive players, and better equipped players. So stay on your starting map quite a while. I mean, a few days until you get a lot of fragments. Now, the second thing is, where is your walker, right? Your walker has storage, and the storage means a few things. Keep all the important materials in your walker. Always have water in it. With 40 water, you can respawn in your walker 2 times. And you can also do a little thing with your walker. For example, you can put weapons and armor in your walker so that you respawn with full health. I think it's also full water. And then you can just take some equipment out of your little walker. And you'll have weapons, armor, you can fight back against whatever killed you and get your stuff back. Now, another very, very important thing is, what do you do on the map? Well, that's quite a tough question. Hold on, I need to build something. Oh, they're taking all the map, okay. Let's put it like that. They're taking all the rope. So, on the map you have 3 possibilities. One is roam around the map doing nothing, which is a silly one. Two, go to the Rumpu village and farm fiber weavers, wooden shafts, and also the urns. The urns are located in their houses, and the bigger houses with the bigger urns have more items in them. So, farming the rupu, their houses, and the urns will get you fragments and all kinds of materials. The second place to farm is the Walker Crash Mountain, or whatever it's called. Here I have a video on how to farm the fragments and all the materials, which is a great way to do it. Now, I recommend you don't keep the raw materials, just craft as much as you can and put it in chest, put it in your walker. For example, let me show you what you can... I got scared there for a moment. Sometimes people will come to steal your stuff. For example, you can put 10 woodcutter's hatchet in a chest or somewhere near you, so you can quickly use them. Okay, this is not mine, this is mine. It's easy as walking or as baking a cake, right? So, put a stack of weapons, usually woodcutter's hatchet. I mean, put 10 weapons, 10 armors, and some smaller armors, and whatever you want. Because you can basically equip yourself with full armor, even if you die once. Now, the second thing is, know what your tools do. The axe is a very, very important tool. Probably the most important, because it's a good melee weapon. If you see barrels like this, destroy them. Everything that has a soft armor, you can destroy it with an axe. And loot them. So this is kind of like the chest, but I already have a video on this, so yeah, watch out for that. Now, the second thing you can do with axes is, of course, knock down the legs of armor. The legs of the walkers. Dingy walker legs. As you can see, this armor is stalled, so we can't destroy it. But this one is soft. Okay, let's not do that because they'll get mad at me. So, you can destroy the walker's leg if they are soft. If you see a firefly that's near you and it's suspicious, just destroy its legs and it will roll down in a very, very cool way. Now, what else you can do with axe? Well, I said it's a good damage weapon and it's a good... it's a very fast weapon. If you're having trouble with flare, just... Okay, let's do it like this. Just use the mountain blade trick and swing left and right in a very, very fast way. Overhead attacks are kind of hard to do. The next tool you want to unlock is the sickle. The sickle is a very, very useful weapon. Actually, it's more like a tool, I said weapon. So that's 2 fiber if you harvest it, but if you take it with the sickle, that's 4. That's 5. I think you can go up to 6. Yeah, 6. And then it resets. So it's kind of a random thing, but sometimes you can get a lot of fiber, meaning you can triple your production from a single bush. So that's a very, very useful tool to have, because otherwise collecting fiber will take forever. Also, have yourself a nice little stack of bandages. Also, a very important thing is to know what everything does. Let's talk more about that, because this is where some people make some big mistakes. So, let's put a few of those over here. There. So, have bandages, weapon, armor. You can have the gloves, the boots, and the headpiece over here as well. It doesn't have to be the best one, but just have it. So, water, weapons, and so on. Now, you know what to do. You know that you don't have to leave the map. You know what to do on the map. You know where to farm this village, and that village. You know that your central base is the Walker. The next question people ask me, or people ask in general, how do you do bone weapons? Well, simply put, there is no bone weapons here. There is no bone fragments on this map. So your tech tree on the cradle the cradle map will only go up to the basically the rope ones. So everything you unlock further than that, you can't build over here, because for example, you don't have nomad cloth on the cradle map. You don't have the whatever else you need, for example, the worm silk and some other things like the redwood wood. Sounds strange. You don't have the beeswax, you don't have the bone splitters, you don't have any of those. So, again, the most important materials on the map are the rupu vines and the hides, and sometimes the rupu pelts because of the armor. So basically, what? It scares me, I can get killed very fast. So basically you need to do a lot of fiber shirt and trousers, the fiber head wrap, the fur sandals, and yeah, this one, the Rufu fur sleeves. As for weapons, the axe is a pretty good weapon, but to be honest, I just like a lot the Jaggard of Maul because it can kill people and things very fast, but it's a weapon against armor. If you want something very, very fast and light, well, you're better off with a travel staff or something like that. It says speed 110, but the animation to hit is slower than the axe or the hatchet. Yeah, so after that, what should you unlock first? Well, as a little side note, this is a base built for a clan. I don't recommend you start building a big base like this because it's a huge, huge task. And you leave the cradle map very fast, but I recommend you farm all your tools, everything you need to know is that the more fragments you have, the more things you unlock. Just unlock everything that uses fragments and not the blocks. Stay as much as you can on the cradle map and farm fragments and also a lot of materials. When you leave the map, you have to be very, very prepared. Have at least 10 stacks of the best weapons and best armor in your Walker. Of course, a lot more water. Now, let's analyze these things a little bit. For example, you have some cactus, which is, you know, boil it and get water. But you also have the huge cactus fruits that are in the Rupu urns in their houses. So yeah, that is 20 water, straight off the bat. The hides again are very important. You get them from killing the rats that are on the map, but they are kind of rare, so you'll have to search a lot of chests. There are chests all over the map, but it's kind of hard to farm them, so yeah. It will be hard for you to do that. Also, if you build a big base, remember to build some doors up there. Or not even a big base, just a small base for yourself, and it will be a 4x4 or just a 2x2. Remember to have one roof tile missing so you can go up the ladder, up to the second floor, and have a door in any direction because the doors are actually the same strength as the walls. And you might want to have yourself a little chest with some javelins, yeah. And if someone really, really makes you mad and talks trash, just get up here. You can switch to first person using X and throw javelins at them and they'll run away. I mean, what can they do? Now, a more important tip is, what do you do when you log off?
Hello.
Well, my recommendation... Don't have time to deal with them. Hello. Okay, my clan member will take care of them. Sadly, most people here will want to hurt you. Sorry about the frame rate, but the frame rate is horrendous on some of the map tiles. The mountain is one of the places where you'll have very, very little frames. For example, you want to build yourself a little house somewhere very, very hidden, like under a wooden structure or something like that. Just build a foundation of one, make walls, make a door, also make the roof, that's very important. So yeah, let's see where that roof is. Make the roof, and then just place a chest, a small chest inside the room, and then you open the door, you enter it, you put some items into the chest, and then you can log out. Otherwise, you'll have to be very, very creative where you log off. Most people just choose a random location, like behind a rock or something, but as I said, choose a random location behind a rock or something, build a little house, one by one tile, build one or two chests inside, and then log out in there, yeah. Also have your walker near it, and you can also put down a sand bed near the area, just in case, you know, you are having some problems. I think this is the, yeah, this is the walker we destroyed the legs. As you can see, if you destroy the walker's legs, sometimes it will roll down the mountain or whatever it is, or it will just stay stuck in there until he builds new legs. And this also applies for people who you kill. If they have water in their walker, they respawn and they can get their weapons very, very fast. So this is kind of like the basic tutorial for new players. As you can see, my he's a very, very happy worker. He almost completed his... I think this is a stiletto. Before I end the video, let's just make a small overview of what you need to unlock first. Let's get up here. So, if you are a new player, it's very important that you know that the game can be played alone. It will be very hard. So, if you want to build a better walker, you need to unlock the vision powder, which is actually created at the fireplace. I don't even have my weapon equipped. Yeah, this can happen, and this will happen very, very often.
Hello, man. Hello.
Anyway, that's enough tips. See you next time. Bye.
Do you remember?